Let's see where we are. So this is an attempt to code something and record it. Someone gave me the idea on Twitter. Hey, why don't you, while you are coding for OptiDoom, why don't you make some videos of, you know, the process and what are you doing and so on. Let's see where I left the project yesterday. And yeah, I think I'm not very confident, you know, talking to the microphone while coding, but I'll try to be natural. I'll see where I left it. I need to fix an annoying bug with the scalers. Let's see. I hope I didn't left it in some place where everything is wrong. I have some numbers that I print because I'm trying to debug the bug. So I've done the scalers before, you have seen them, but there is a bug, and the bug is this. Is it here? This is the 1x2. Scale the pixels in vertical. It also gets darker, but that's another. I'm not sure why. That's not the bug. So this is the bug. This mode and this mode. Do you see on the right side? On the right side of the columns, there are some broken columns. I can't figure out what it is, but it has to do with the fact that some lookup tables are created. And every time you change the scale, every time you change the screen size, just one screen size lower and it's fine. The right side of the game screen. You put it here, just for few columns, you get these errors. In the, I don't know if it's visplanes, I don't know. A lot of lookup tables, four lookup tables are generated every time you change the screen size or the scalers. And it happens when the horizontal pixel is halved. And that's the odd thing, because here I have a lot of junk. I have commented out lines where I was trying to print things. Those five numbers, those five zeros, when I enable the frame rate. So this init math tables, every time as I change the, this is the screen size option, these are the widths and the heights for the different screen size options. This existed before. What changed here, of course, is that later this screen widths and heights are halved based on the screen scale X and Y. This can either be 0 or 1, so you shift right 0 bits, so these values are the same, or you shift right 1 bits, so they are divided by 2, they are halved. Because this width and height and center X, Y and the offset, all these are used, and here some lookup tables are created. And I was trying to print here, for example, one of the lookup tables, or maybe more, are corrupted. And I was trying to print column 0, the last column, column screen width minus 1, the one in the middle, the one at 1/4 and 3/4. So it's like, I don't know if my mouse pointer, one on the left, one on the center, one on the middle. So I was trying to I'm interested on the ones on the right side. Maybe I should print screen width minus 1. Those are the one I'm interested. Minus 2. I was just trying to print everything. Maybe I should print the last 5. I'm putting this on some temp 0 variable, which on 3 do, that's the main. This is where the Doom code starts. And at some point I'm print number. Yeah. Where is it? At some point I'm printing the frame rate and I'm printing these 5 numbers. I use this temporary array. Let's see, this goes on air data. Let's see these values here to view angle. You have x to view angle to x. These are relevant to. They are used in the wall renderer. Now, if the wall renderer is wrong, it's gonna generate wrongly the visplanes, which will also affect the floor and ceiling render, which seems to be spilling. So now I'm gonna print the last 5. Because yesterday I was, few days ago when I was working, I was printing. I wanted to see uniformly 5 columns. I can't print anything, it's hard to debug. So I print the lookup table for the x0, x at the end of the width screen, in the middle, in some places. But maybe I'm missing something. And I'm printing just to see if the numbers make sense and which of the 4, there are 4 lookup tables, which of the 4 lookup tables is screwed for some reason. Maybe, let's see. Oh, these are all big numbers. Yeah, I'm not sure right now what the numbers mean. I just want to see. Some of the all of the numbers. It's hard to see with the menu. So I want to see when you change, if some of the numbers become totally different, totally weird when I change this scale. I think it's okay. So this is how I might do something else. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what it is, and I'm not sure what it is because back in the days, let me try that actually. Back in the days, before I make this scaling functionality and the fit to screen. The fit to screen is good because we can finally fit it. There are bars on the left and right, now we can stretch it a bit and fit it fully. But much previously I thought, hey, I can add a bigger screen size. I'm gonna add it here now. I can add this without scaling. This is what I did a long time ago, and I think I had the same mistake, but it made sense then. It made sense because you put a bigger width and maybe this is exceeding some of the lookup tables we are using to generate those lookup tables. So it's out of the box. But when you do the scaler, the width is divided. So I don't understand how. And I thought of screen ratio. I thought if the width gets half but the height is the same, then the height divided by width, the screen ratio changes, and maybe this overflows something on the calculations on the lookup tables. So now it's gonna go. I'm not even gonna change the size, it's already the biggest size. Yeah, it's screwed. But it's screwed in a different way, surprisingly. You can't easily add bigger screen size. Oh. I wanted to try something. What did it reset? We have a screw situation now here, and this video will be just that. Me trying to find out this bug. This is the final bug for the. Let me reduce the screen size. Okay. So the bigger screen size now. If I put back the bigger, it's 320 pixels on X. It's not 280. But what if I first do the scale and then put it? Now it works. It's 320 divided by half. And wait a minute. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Now, interesting. This doesn't even do the. That tells me something. You don't even see the bug. If I make the screen size. Whoa. Ah, the lower screen size. Yeah. I'm not sure about these videos. It might gonna be boring. It might be just my progress, and so that you see how I work. I see those coding videos where someone is coding for an hour, and I rarely see them. But it was an idea from someone to say, "Hey, let's do it. Maybe it will." Whoa. A lot of weird stuff are happening. But see, the bug on the right side is not. In those two scaling modes, there used to be with a bigger screen size. With the smaller, it didn't exist. And that tells me, of course, this 320 maybe exceeds the something in the calculation that reads from some lookup tables. But that tells me something other. But it does work. Yeah, 320. If you half the width, you go to 160 because of the scaler. It suddenly fits in the lookup tables. So maybe then, yeah. So that's why I couldn't use 320. I had to use 210. That tells me something. It might be the number. It might not be just the size, because divide them by half and you have much smaller width, and suddenly you might be able to fit there in the limited tables. So let's see. View to angle. This is the one we generate. And there is this fine tangent. There are some divisions. It's hard to understand. So there are some lookup tables outside of this. We're just gonna see that, just to show you. Here are the lookup tables. Tangent and cotangent and all that stuff. Fine tangent. This is 4096. And where was I? Here is where we use that lookup table to generate our own lookup tables. View angle to X. These are all used somewhere in the rendering of the walls or the floors and ceilings, maybe. I think in the rendering of the walls, this one. I lost it. View to angle X. Create the view angle to X. Using view angle to X, create X to view angle. And I think what those do is you give an X coordinate on the screen and it returns you the angle. So possibly if you give 160 the middle of the screen, it could possibly return you 0. And that's without the... That's my thinking. But as you move away from the middle of the screen, the angles on the left and the right, they are increasing or decreasing. And these are used to know where... I'm not sure where to render the columns, or they are used in other ways to find the heights of the columns and the distance and a lot of other trigonometric stuff. And that's the angle too. And there is the... Where is it? I'm a bit slow, sorry. Psi slope and distance scale. These are used on the floor rendering, floor ceiling rendering. I had an idea now, let me see. 320 divided by half, it worked. But 280 divided by half, 140. 280 works. 280 divided by half doesn't work. So if I put a bigger number than 280, I get into other problems because of some limit. Not notepad. Calculator. I was trying to think of something yesterday. 280. I'm not sure what's going on yet. I need to study it in another way. My next idea, but I'm not going there, is to go to the renderer and print, and because I can't, from the visual results I cannot guess. Just checking if this one records. I could be doing this all the time and not get it. Ah, God. If the number is not, it is divided. It's not divided by 16. If there is something like that, that's divided by 16. Yeah, that's divided by 16. That has to be divided. So this one is not divided by 16 to 72. Can we get... Yeah, I'm just speculating here. Because I have the biggest width, 280. When I use the scaler that halves the width, it goes 140, so it's even smaller. So possibly the lookup tables are not exceeding something. Then it gets me the wrong columns, but when you put 320, that one unscaled, one by one, it's gonna be screwed. But when you do the scaler and goes to 160, which is bigger, but it's inside the limits of the lookup tables, I don't know, then it works. I thought the higher value, even if you scale it by half, it would not work, the same as 280. So it might not just be the size, it might be... I'm speculating now. Maybe this is also outside, but then I... If that doesn't work, I'm gonna put the 272. And all the other numbers are divided by 16. It's mumbo jumbo now. What I'm doing is a bit mumbo jumbo. I'm guessing. We need to find when the bug doesn't happen, or I was trying to print values. Sometimes this is how you debug, and it's very hard on. Maybe I'll go in the column render and I will print some values for the last few columns on the right side somehow, so that I deduce what's going on. So now that's a bit bigger width, but it's a width number that is divided by 16 like the others. It doesn't fail. So I created a bit bigger mode. Ah, no, I'm in this one. Let's see this one. It fails, but... does the scaler fail? The scaler doesn't fail on the right side. Interesting. Let's put something that at least it's smaller. As we say, I'm smelling my fingers. I don't know where it's. It's a Greek proverb. When you are like, I don't know what am I doing. You know this picture with the dog. I noticed patterns. That's the thing. I don't know why this happens. This bug happens. I will investigate it later, but. Oh boy. Ah, that's normal. You know, the border around, there is a border around this, the brown border around the game area. There are fixed assets where it's a border around and inside it's black or transparent. And there are 6 different assets to blend the border at the end after the. So, because I reduced the. You see this kind of bugs, but that's fine. This one is fine. Let's see. Oh. I see the last column. Something happens with the last column. Something totally happens with the last comb, but the other ones are not screwed. Oh god. Let's try my theory. If this goes not 256, if it goes 260. If the number was not nice, would this also fail? Remember, the bug is the last few columns. I think I'll go in the renderer next. I can investigate the generation of the... But I don't know why I'm not doing it now. Yeah, because I have other things in my mind. It's the right thing to do also. I also got a coffee. I guess this video will be kinda raw and boring, and whoever wants to watch, I can't make them better. So let's see. So this is kinda bigger screen size on. It's like 4 pixels bigger on X. Let's see. Yeah, see? The columns are screwed. There has to be fewer columns, though. Or is it? It's when they start to get screwed. These are 2 pixels. Hmm. 256. That's a nice number. It's divided by half, it's 128. It is the screen. What happens? What happens? This is the culprit. The screen width, when it's divided by half, because the scaler, the screen scale here is 1. So when we have, when the scale on X is 2, is double pixel. The pixel is doubled on X. In 2 by 1 and 2 by 2, in both, then things start falling apart. Oh, I wanna see this stretch. Stretch, stretch. Screen width and screen height. I thought at the beginning it has to be a ratio. But it doesn't happen in 2 by 1, where the width happens to be half of the height. It also happens in 2 by 2, where the ratio is like the 1 by 1. Again. Stretch. Define stretch width height. 160 divided by width, screen width, multiplied by height, divided by, yeah, I mean, if the width, if the scale was 1 by 1, this would be even bigger, so it's not an overflow. 160 divided. By width multiplied by I don't know directly what that does. Where is this stretch used? In stretch width. That could be a ratio thing, this stretch. Where is this stretch? I mean, you see it. Oh, it's here. I just want to put the parentheses because I'm missing the parentheses. Divided by, and then you multiply that. Inverted with multiplied it by height. So it's like it's height divided by width, really. Oh, that could, yeah. Yeah, okay, it's here the height is above the, it's height divided via, divided by a number. Via, via is the Greek. Divide, and here is this number divided by width, so it really becomes shut up. Mathematically, it would become so generally, it's a ratio of height by width. And it would make sense. It would make sense. We have this scalar. No, this scalar. This is the pixel scalar. It means that if you had this resolution, the real resolution will become half of the width. So this width will become smaller, much smaller compared to the height. And that could make this number grow, and maybe there could be an overflow here. This is a fixed point number. Maybe there could be no, but maybe there is not. I mean, wait a minute. We could do it. 160. By. I'm wondering how big this video is. And I'm a bit slow. The height is 160. I mean, we can just divide by 180, divide by the width is 140. I think it would be okay. It's multiplied by 2.2 and it's multiplied by this fixed point. It will be very well. It's not a big number. I think that would be okay. And as I say, the bug happens in this, in 2x1, but the bug happens in 2x2, which will equally half the width and the height. So why would it happen? So that's not it. I don't think it is. I want to see. So we create this stretch width, which we this stretch width we multiply stretch by screen width. Here is the screen width again. And screen width halved again. And I mean the screen width is... No, it's 140, yeah. Where do we use this stretch width? There is a fixed point division here. Let's see. That's the only place. The vertical slope. That this is for the floor rendering. The bank seems to on the floor, but it's on the columns, I think. Again, the screen width is the culprit. Where do we use them? T equals screen width plus 1. Damn it. For the love of God, I don't know. I can't see directly here where things go bad. So what I might do, let me see. Okay, what tables do we have? Field of view, wait a minute, field of view. Oh, it's just a constant number. Fine angles. Center X. Yeah, center X is based on screen width. It is gonna be half now, so it doesn't overflow anything. I think frag unit. What is this frag unit? 1 6 frag bits. Okay, go. I'm not gonna get much like this. I haven't sat down to really understand these tables. to be honest, but we're gonna go to another place. How long am I recording? 35 minutes, oh my god. Who's gonna watch? If you like it, watch it. It's just my progress. I got stuck and I'm slow. So this video is gonna be what it's gonna be. I think it should be either this X to view angle or view angle to X. I'm gonna go to where is it? View angle to X. Let's take that one maybe. I'm gonna go here on Total Commander and make a search. Oh, what am I pressing? It's on phase one. This is the code for the BSP. And it's used there. This is there, that this is where we created. Everything is defined on the tables. Max screen width plus one, max screen width. This is really used on phase one. How about the phase one has to do with the BSP mostly. Where's the other one? Where's the other one? My mind is stuck. The X to view angle. This is used much more. My god, it's used everywhere. What is this? Late prep. So much thing on the rendering. I could focus on the phase 6. Phase 6 1. Seg loop sky. Okay. I'm gonna try that. This is the columns for the sky. If it also happens on the sky, which is easier to see, we have to deduce that it's this table and not something else. If it happens on the walls. There is way more things happening with the walls. If it happens on the sky, not sure though, because even the sky positions are informed by the walls. The open area that remains that could be sky. I don't remember what we did with let's see. Yes, okay. The bug is there. So, let's have the sky. Let's do it. Oh. There is no bug in the wall. Sometimes there is, okay. Are there bugs in the sky? God awful bugs. There are bugs below. Okay, these are bugs in the wall, but not in the sky, maybe. I'm not sure. I'm really not sure. You never know. Why this last? How many columns are they? 3, 4? Oh, here they are more. Maybe 5. Why these last few columns? Again, these last few columns on the right side of the screen get screwed a bit. And they only get screwed. They don't get screwed in full. Or 1x2. They get screwed by 2x1. When the screen width is actually reduced. I can't make sense of it. And in this scale, if you just go one size lower, it's fine. It's like we hit something. It's not the sprite, of course, it's just the... This is a god-awful bug. And I know somewhere visplanes are created, and if the visplanes get screwed up, this is a kind of a bug you would see. So I'm gonna open phase 6. So maybe it's good because we searched for x to view angle and we found a lot of places. That's a lot of places to look. This phase 6 has to do with the wall rendering. Phase 6.1. These are other steps of the rendering. What is phase 6.2? This still has to do with the draw wall segment full. We're still there are a lot of things happening till you finally render a wall. Render a column of a wall. And I have broken them in sub-steps. Oh, okay. The bulk of the work happens in 6.1 and 6.2. 6.1, we have something for the sky. Here is the visplane algorithms too. Seg loop floor. Seg loop sky. But maybe it's not the x to view angle that happens in the sky. Maybe it's, if we reduce the possibilities, it's good. Maybe it's, let me go back again. X to view angle, the view angle to x. Which is not used, but the view angle to X is used on the phase 1 only. Okay, you know, we'll go to phase 1. Phase 1, I have opened a lot of stuff here. This has mostly to do with the BSP, it's a very early stage. And we have, I hope the bug is here, because there are less to search, and I mean, you hope the bug is here, but it's pretty complicated, and I haven't touched this code. This is the BSP, this is a very pre-early step, the BSP traverse, that gives you what well renders towards, and I have touched the ledge. I have touched phase 6, and phase 6.1.2, I splitted that. Maybe phase 7 or 8. But it's not even... It might not be hard. Here we add clips, the given segment that's invisible. That's a later step of the BSP. Given something, this is where it adds the lines, I guess the walls, in a later step. So maybe it's not that hard. Where is I missed now? I missed my search. My search was for view to angle x. View angle to x. I'm confused. So it converts the angles. At some point in this step, it has angles. I forget the BSP algorithm. And it's converted on the, I guess that could be left side and right side of a wall, X coordinate on the screen. And it comes from angles. Damn it. I'm thinking what to do here. I might print some stuff. Something with the angles because we. If you print things here, it can be anything. That's the problem. It's funny that it uses the angle here. It converts to a coordinate. It's not an angle anymore, but it uses the same variable, just to not create more variables. Those here say angle, but they must be really... This is too small to bother in for it. Word clips or it was I haven't ever studied this code. The thing is, now we are gonna traverse all the walls and we're gonna get some angles. Some x coordinates from the angles, but it's not gonna be the last one. No, you know what? I'm going on the phase 6. Because if the problem is the columns, I'm gonna print something about the columns. We're gonna find a case where the column values are very odd, are not what looks okay, and then we go backwards, we investigate, okay, why does this happen? If goal quality high, draw seg full. Draw plane, screen width. Could be here too. Half of this video already is garbage. I don't even know if I will post it at the end. Damn. Draw seg full. We go to phase 6-1. It's not here. Where is it? 6-2. Yeah. I don't know anymore. vis call scale. I have forgotten. Here is where x2 view angle is used. Texture column. What was the texture column? I have forgotten, it's not the... Is it the... or the scale is the scale. He start x start x end. We could... I really don't know how to do this. I'm tired. Because you could, we have the temp. Let's go deeper. Where is that? Is it on phase 7? No. Is it on 6.1? It's on the 6PL. Wait. Oh, it's here. The PL is the polygon based. Visual. Draw war segment. We're gonna get the full one here. The Doom rendering code is insane. No, this is drawing a wall segment. Do wire. So, this is gonna draw a wall, and the wall could be for from 0 to 100, for example, on the screen, horizontally. So it will loop through every column and render the columns individually. It will add them in the CCB pointer. This is the cell stuff here. But what we need to see is what is the height that is given. Now this text might be holding. It says text for texture, but I think it holds the X coordinate on the screen. Where does the first column start? And we could edit it, iterates till the last one. And this is the vertical. No, the horizontal, the vertical coordinate of the horizontal vector in the cell. This is the column scale. This really gives us the column scale. Why is it bad? I might do something here. I might say it's time after a lot of time talking slowly and being confused. just and I know why this is gonna, it's not gonna be perfect, but maybe we can learn something. And I'm gonna just store the scale. The last, just to be safe, because I think temp 0, where do we have, okay, it has 5 values now. This is all we print. I'm lost again. This is awful debugging. There is no way to make, you know, click and make a breakpoint. This, I'm just using code blocks. I don't know why. I'm fine with the editor. I'm not compiling from code, but I'm just using it as an editor. Sometimes I'm using Notepad++. I don't know why nobody likes code blocks. The editor at least is fine. And some of my project data will compile from with batch files and anyway. I'm just using it as an editor. So I'm gonna print the last columns that are at position X to 75 to 79, almost to 80. We will render it scale. But the thing is, if you have I can have a single wall, but if you have some stairs, they are different. This function is gonna be called for a wall segment, and it can have other wall segments above, upper texture, lower texture, stairs. So I might not get what I want unless I stick to a single wall. It will give me something. Let's see it. Did I do it? I did it. It will constantly prompt. I don't know the range of this VC scale. I don't remember it. I'm drinking coffee. How long have I been recording? Sometimes I think I'm gonna post it anyways, but can I post it after I find the bug? It could take me 3 hours. Sometimes it's so. Here goes nothing. So I'm getting the scale. I cannot show with the pointer. I'm getting the scale of the last 5 wall columns, and does it make sense? Let's go closer to a wall. On the right side of the gaming screen, the last 5 columns, yeah, it grows. It's a scale that goes, maybe it goes to 4000, it goes even bigger. So if you go fast, it's, see, for example, I'll get, now the last 5 columns on the screen is in the white wall in the back. But if I rotate, it's gonna be some closed columns here. That was my theory, but it doesn't seem. Oh no, it is. Are there things outside? Oh, is it on the left side? No, it's not on the. Anyway, I think I have them. Let me see something. No. You can never be sure. Anyway, let's see what happens when you change the scale. First of all, the screen is half. The pixel scale is half height. We halve the height and then we scale it up again to give the double pixel. So, of course it goes half, about half. But let's see if it's not some uniform values, but some very screwed stuff. Oh. They don't even print. Wait a minute. They don't change. Oh, I'm an idiot, sorry. If we scale that half, we go to 140. I'm just putting numbers here. Yeah. And I guess the width is 280 in the bigger resolution, so it's 140. I was printing values for columns outside. This is the dumbest debugging video. I don't know if I will even. I will just post it and waste you an hour or two of your life because I might even want to post when I find the bug and when I correct. You know, see, this thing can take your evening. I thought this would have gone better, but I don't know. Yeah, it makes sense that. Let's go to. Four, three, seven, four, two, one. Ah, yeah, bigger number, bigger scale. The numbers look okay. Is it not that? You know, the columns are wrong there, but. Oh, God. I think it's the visplane. It's. Is the floor ceiling, but why? It might not even be the words, you know. Else those numbers would not be very close to each other. It would be one would be 376, the other would be 150. Would be very screwed. Okay, it's not the scaling. The columns are rendered fine. It's the visplanes that comes next. It's the visplanes. So let me. Where are the visplanes? How are the? It's always a nightmare. It's on 6-1. Find plane. I see it. I fucking see it. I see it. I see it. It has to be the number. This was a loop unrolling of the visplanes. It has to be that. That must be the bug. And to make it 8 times, it divide the screen width by 8. And you have I think that must be it. You have this. Come on. You halved it because of the horizontal scalar, the scalar of the x pixel, double pixel on x. That's the screen width. It divides by 8. I think that's it. Ah, my God. There was a loop unrolling here to make it faster. And this number, if you take the other, this is the previous screen width, 256. You make it half because of the x scalar, and then you divide it by 8, it divides perfectly. This is why I was dividing by 16 before, because I had seen a pattern, I just wasn't sure. This is it. This damn thing. We're gonna make the unrolling a bit worse. I could maybe, and I was putting some other numbers to prove it, but it didn't seem to. That's the bug. It had to do with that screen width wasn't divided by 16, because God. I'm wondering if this takes much of the performance. Maybe it's minimal. There are a lot of things, but let's see. I didn't thought I would find it so fast. I was thinking, but you know, my initial guess was right. I was just putting a number from 280. I was putting 272 and 288, and I was still seeing some weird bug. And so I thought, hey, maybe that's not it. God, but I saw it instantly. I think this video would be 3 hours, me cursing. That has to be. Yeah. Yes. That's it. Bug found. Oh my God. All the other screen sizes are divided. I think you got what happened. With the scalar, we divided the screen width 280 to 140. And this loop unrolling would divide the screen width by 8 before. This has to do with the visplanes. It would fit. It would divide perfectly by 8. Then 140, that is 280 divided by half. So for this specific screen width of the biggest size, it just wouldn't fit. God. The other screen width would divide very nicely. By 16. By 2 when you use the scalar, and by 8 here. Now, it's always good to have loop unrolling. I mean, I'm gonna check the if I save that, because it has to do with the performance. Also, I think if I put it divide by 4 and do only 4 unrolls per loop, then the performance hit will be minimal. It would be, you wouldn't even see it, because there are so many other places where this. I mean, what does this do? It's just filling all the visplanes. The visplanes are, come on, that's minimal. I don't even need to test it. Yeah, but let's test it. By the way, it is fast because I'm running it overclocked, so it's easier to do things. Let's see. 19 frames. So what if I this set takes values from 0 to screen with, okay. This set, this array has a size of screen width in the max opening 208, and we fill 208 values with this open max. It's a very simple thing. Come on, it's minimal. Let's just try it. And if we see 18 frames instead of 19, it shouldn't matter. Could be very, very close. Normally you need to have some timer count, some I don't know, some high quality timer to find. So the way I'm checking the frame rate is very crude. It's 19 again, and okay, it's, let me see. Now it's not easy to, at this point, this 13. Oh, let's put this size. I should be closing this boring video. I found the bug. This is so minimal, okay? It's just a loop through 208 values, or 104, 208 in the course case. And you fill it with a number, it's minimal. I can just scrub the, reduce the, you know, the unrolled. Now it's doing, every 8 elements is doing an unroll. But that creates the bug. I can reduce it to 4. 4 times per loop, so that I don't have the crazy bug. Around this corner, 12. This scene here is start to getting slow. This is a this camera view. I always test this one because it has more visplanes. It has more visplanes because of these lights above and the stairs maybe here and the lights there and those sectors here. There is a lot of visplanes in the view. This is one of I'm trying to test, and really, if you put the default, it's pretty slow, man. It's killing me. Oh, by the way, Tom, 4DO for some reason, this is not the real, if you put this on the real 3DO, I'm not sure in this view, but in some other views, the frame rate is a bit higher. Something, the arm cycles might be wrong. The Phoenix doesn't, but I just prefer to run 4DO. It starts up faster, 4DO. Unless I need to check something specific on Phoenix with the cell rendering speed, and I think maybe the real, the speed that will be equivalent will be something like that. It's still slow. It's cool though when you put the scalars. You know, oh no, yeah, yes, now I have the code with the bug, the original code, with the 8 repeats per loop for the unrolling. Divides the screen width by 8. I don't know if it's visible. I'm gonna make this a bit bigger. One reason I put the scalars, I could say that. I used to have this scaler. And this scaler for the floor. And there are a lot of, for the wall rendering, there are a lot of paths. There is a path that renders the wall, there is a path that creates the visplanes, and this would really render half of the columns with a double scaled on the X. And so you would do half of the loops in the process for the column, but it wouldn't. The visplanes would still be high res, and the visplanes are the most important. Because I couldn't. If I skipped some columns in the visplanes, there would be visplane spills and bugs. So I decided. One reason I decided to make and see the bugs there. Do you see the flashing pixels? There were some There were some gaps. It wasn't a good method. So my idea is scale by half the whole render a half width. And scale that, because that would half the width, the game width, and the visplane code, the column rendering code, everything will do half loops, so it would be faster. So the old method, I keep the old method, I'll do this to be fair. Let's see, put it here, 14 frames. So, this is half columns, half floors, but the sprites are still high res. So the old method would not be optimal. 14. If you do this... Oh, it's less, it's 13, I don't know why it is. In some views it's faster. That's a failure. It's pretty bizarre. At least this one is faster. I struggle a lot with it. I'll tell you something else. Sometimes 1x2 vertical scale is faster than 2x1. 14 frames. And if I change some view, this is 16, it's still 14. I have noticed it, and it depends on the angles you are viewing the visplanes or something. You know what, I had enough with this video. I'm just standing here. We found the bug, that's it. I don't promise anything. I promise. Oh god, I need to clean up now. Shit. This is my private repository of temp zero. I don't need the temp zero anymore. Get rid of it. Yeah, this is the fix. Is there anything else? Temp 0, blah blah blah. Oh good, I can revert all of it. Such a weird bug. I might need this temp 0 in the future, but hey. It's okay, I always type this again. Let's clear up. So that's the small change for such a weird bug that I thought originally, oh my god, it must be the lookup tables that are created with all this weird math. So one of the screens of the six screen widths on all the six sizes just wasn't a good number. You just had to reduce the loop unrolling, and it's minimal on performance because it's nothing compared to what happened. So we repeat the unroll code 4 times instead of 8 so that it's fine with the half width of all the scales. And that's the bug, maybe I'll say. Fix the damn bug. Motherfucking. Yeah. Okay, maybe I'll call it nasty. Yeah. It's your last. Really, this plane. When using to buy on. I guess that's it. This is my private repository of OptiDoom. Because I do a lot of changes, and sometimes I try things and I have dirty code. I will push this later. No, let's push it now. I have a lot of stuff here. I think my other stuff is... It's a simple change, so... I made changes, but I reverted it. It's here. Phase 6-1. That's how I work, guys. That's the only change. Just to see if this compiles. This is the official Git repository, so I work on the private repository. I commit stuff that I don't want to commit directly. It works. Let's try it once. I have all these batch files to run for the O. I'm gonna overhaul these mod options. Scan, I'm gonna add new stuff. The screen scalers and fit to screen was one of the three things, one of the three major things I wanted to do for the OptiDoom version. I'm gonna put it, set, call it 0.2b. Oh, I'm printing the numbers. I know. This is OptiDoom ISO. All this is copying the OptiDoom ISO to the emules. But I don't select it, just opens the last one. And the last one I'm calling it demo. Because I was doing some demo coding in the beginning. But here on the official OptiDoom. And this one is showing also the. The titles. I have disabled the sound. I enable it when I want to check something with the sound. Yeah, I have a define on the unofficial repo to not show the title screens in the video, just to go faster. Maybe I could also make it skip the mod menu. Yeah, and I realized because it was printing the other five zeros, the other values. No problem. Okay, fixed. And this is one of the it's over now. Now I'm gonna show you more stuff. Did I commit? Now I'm committing on the official one. Fix the. And here is an official commit. I'm gonna show you what I have invested a lot on OptiDoom. Gonna show you. So let's go here. And I have this tonic project. This is a bit at my real job. We are using tracks, so I thought to motivate me and with OptiDoom and the other, maybe I should make my own track. But I downloaded some files related to track, and I didn't know what I was doing. Somehow I installed it, so that I go here and I have projects, 3D experiments. Bizarro engine, my grid-based 3D. I never even started that. I just have things I want to do. With zero. But the project I work is the OptiDoom 3DO. This is like a project manager thing, and I thought it would be a cool idea. Oh, no. It's called Tonic because I wanted to make a game called Tonic, an FPS for the PC, but it's one of these big things I never start. But I think I will end up in the future doing the Bizarro engine for the 3DO. I want to really start a new 3D engine on the 3DO. But for now I'm using this for few of my projects. I have way much more things. I'm using this to take notices, have tickets. It's meaningless because it's one person, it's me. Usually it's meaningful when there are more people working. And I could have used Trello, I could have used something else. So now I'm gonna find. You might even see things I might want to do. Although I have more in my mind, I'm gonna find. It must be on 02B. add scaler options in the menu. So I was going on the scaler and feed to screen. This is almost finished, blah blah blah. Yeah, that was our bug. So resolve is fixed. Definitely found the done bug. Committed. I'm not putting the commit numbers here. I didn't connect it. It's just a motivational thing. I mean, just to see, and also to remember things I wanted to do to fix. So every time I notice something, I go here and open a ticket. And that's it, I think. What happened? I don't know. I think that's it, guys. It's 1 hour and a half video. Whoever watches it, watches it. I don't care. Maybe you will find it interesting. I could do more videos. I could do a video where I want to add another gimmick, splitting the screen in a grid to do distortion effects, and that would be more fun to see something in action. This is how I struggle with a nasty bug. Okay, it took me 1 hour and a half, maybe 1 hour and something. This video is experimental. I don't know if you like it. Maybe some people will find it interesting. I guess see you at another video or something. Bye.